Hi, I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au and I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner. In this quick tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate how we can add an attachment to a Mailchimp email marketing campaign and how we can link to a Google Docs document and a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet. The first thing to say is an important concept to understand when we're adding an attachment to an email marketing campaign in Mailchimp. Now, in Outlook, Gmail, Yahoo, Hotmail, when we send an attachment, what we do is we attach the file and send the file itself to the person, the recipient. So we forcibly send that file to the recipient. In Mailchimp, it's slightly different. What we do is we actually link to the file, and then when the person clicks to view the file, it loads for the person at that time. But I'll demonstrate how this is done. As you can see, I'm creating my email marketing campaign. So in the content section, what I'll do is I'll demonstrate how we can link to a PDF file. To link to the PDF file, what you would normally do is you would use a button. So I'll just drag and drop the button wherever I want it to appear. And I'll just highlight the text that says add button text and change it to something like download now. So this might be the PDF file, your pricing sheet, or you know, your newsletter in PDF format, whatever. Then as we're looking at it, to the left-hand side of the screen, we change the link to be, so I've clicked the down arrow and click file. Now, Mailchimp says to me, add the file. So I can click the down arrow and either I can select file that I've already uploaded to my Content Studio or I can upload from my computer. But let me just click select from Content Studio. Now, this is actually a PDF file that I uploaded a little bit earlier. If you don't already have a file here you want to send to people to allow people to download, you can always just upload from your computer. But once you've got it in your Content Studio, I'm just going to click that file and click Insert. So now what's going to happen is when you send this email to someone, email campaign to someone, when they click on it, at that time, that file will download for them. So that's how we add an attachment in Mailchimp. Then, how do we link to, for example, a Google Docs document? Because maybe you want to make changes to the file that you send to people. So maybe you have a work group and you want to send a sort of document that everyone can update. Well, using Google Docs or online version of Microsoft Word, for example, is perfect. But here's a Google Docs. And all I would do in this case is I'll just share the file first of all. Let's just click share and let's share with others. Then I need to change the restricted, and you can change this to how you want to share it, but I'll just go anyone with link. What I'm going to do is copy the link. Okay, so I've got the link now to the Google Docs document. Going back to Mailchimp, let's say I want to link to that file on the button. Let me just change the text to edit now, for example. And what I would do is, because this is now a URL I'm linking to, it's no longer a file, I would use web as the link to, so web, and just paste in your Google Docs web there. Simple. If you're sharing, for example, a Microsoft spreadsheet that's online that you want people to be able to edit and view, you would also, just as we did in Google Docs, you would share this. So we'll go share. Let's just copy the link, but you could also click share, but I'll just copy the link, for example. We'll just wait a second or two for Excel to copy that link. There we go. We'll copy it. And once again, on your button, we can just link to that Excel sheet. So when someone clicks on it, they'll go straight to that online sheet. Of course, with any of these attachments or linking to an external file, we don't have to use a button. We can add some text, so we could just add some text. Here is the file as promised, I don't know, something like that. And let's just link to our PDF file again, but could be any link. So let's just do file as promised, and I'll just click the little link button. And again, I'll click the file And I can either select from my Content Studio or upload, but I'll just go Studio just for this example, click on my file, click Insert, and click Save. So once again, when someone now clicks on that link, they'll download the file immediately and be able to view it. But please like this video and please subscribe to my channel. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.